Okay, so let's get started building our Canvas app. But just let's remember what we are doing here. We are going to build a model-driven app for products and orders management with the intention to use it inside the company, and then a Canvas app for the customers to request products to create their purchase orders. That's what we are doing through the series. And now we are going to go to the Canvas app. We already have our first table in the model-driven app. We already understand a little bit how it works. Let's understand how the Canvas app connects to the Dataverse tables. And we want something like this, a gallery of products, so the user can choose one of the available products. We just have the products table, so this will be very simple. We are just going to show them in the app. Later, we are going to add filters, create the possibility to place orders, and so on. But this will be the foundation of the whole series. In order to create our Canvas app for our mobile device, we are going to go to our solution. I explained earlier that we needed a solution to organize things, and here's my solution. I'm already on it. My solution is called Commercial System, and I'm going to go to a new app and select Canvas app. Once I clicked on it, I can provide the app name and choose the format. I'm going to choose phone because it's going to be used on the phones. So to me, I think it's easier to start with the correct format than having to adapt later. The app name will be called My Product Orders. I will also put a dash mobile just to make it easier to recognize when you're editing things. Okay, let's click on Create, and it will open the blank canvas where we are going to start building our app. If you are completely new, then I have another playlist that I can leave here in the pinned comments, or if you forget, just ask me in the comments, that I teach how to build an app from scratch, and I teach all the steps inside this canvas interface. But now I'm going to consider that you already know a little bit, so I won't go explaining the basics, otherwise it will take too long. Here we have the blank canvas, and the first thing we are going to do in our app is to connect to our data source. That's the Dataverse table called products. Here in the left, in the data panel, I click on it, and then I can click on add data. Once I click on add data, I can see the tables on my environment, and I can search the table I want. In this case, it will be products. So it's in here, products, Microsoft Dataverse. I click on it and it's added to my app. Now I have access to the same table that I used in the model-driven app. If by any reason I update in the model-driven app, it will already reflect in here because it's the same data. Okay, now in order to display this information, we have the gallery. The gallery is used to display information. So I'm going to go to Insert and search for gallery. Okay, here we have vertical gallery, horizontal and flexible height gallery. I'm going to select vertical gallery. Okay, once I insert, a blank gallery will be inserted to my Canva, and then I can select the data source. If I don't select any data source, we can see that in the items properties, we have custom gallery sample. That's just a table with sample data that Power App offers in order for us to see at least any information here and see how it works. Okay, so I'm going to click in the gallery and I'm going to select the products table. Here in the right pane, we have the data source and we can select the products. Once I click on it, it will load the product information. Let me zoom in a little bit, and we see that here we have the picture, the product name, and the product code. In my case, it already detected good fields to show here, but I could change. For example, if I don't want the product code, but the category, I can just click in that label that's inside the gallery, in this case called subtitle 1, and change to this item dots. Category, let me search product category, and then it's showing the category of my product. Just to remember, the gallery has all the items of my table, and in order to configure what's going to show, I just need to configure the first row of the gallery. And then the same design replicates to all the items. In order to access the information of the product, we access this item that represents the row and then the column. In this case, dot product name will show the name of the product. Let me get this gallery and make it occupy the full size of the screen, just to make easier to visualize everything. And then hit play here in the top right. I can preview the app and see the information showing already here. Okay, this by itself doesn't help much, but it's the foundation of our app, because now we can see all the products. We could add, for example, the shopping cart button, a button to see the details, because we still have the description of the products to visualize. We can add filters here and so on. The next thing I want to do here is to filter these products, just to remove the ones that are inactive. Remember that in the previous video, we learned about activating or deactivating products, and we have these views of active and inactive products. In my case, I have this beer 001, and there's another beer here that I inactivated because I'm saying it's out of stock that I don't want to show here. So beer 001 is showing here, it's just a sample data, I don't want to use it. And also this Azores Pale Ale, it's out of stock, I don't want to show it in here because I don't want my user to order a product that's not in stock. So if I click in the gallery, we have here in the right pane the views property. So we can select a view. In this case, we have 5 views. The other 3 views we didn't see yet what they are, but we have active products and inactive products. If I click on active products, it will already compose the filter to show only the active products. So before I had just products in here in the items property, now I have a filter filtering the products table by passing the view name that I want to filter. So if I go to the views in the model-driven app, in the table configuration, and change the way the view is filtered, it will already reflect here in the app. That's very good, because if I want to change how it behaves, I don't need to open here and edit the app, since it's filtering by the view. Okay, now we see only the products that are active. Let's go and publish this app. There is this publish button here in the top right. I'm going to publish, and then I'm going to play the app as a user would do. I'm going to go to make.powerapp.com. The user would have it installed on the mobile phone, but he could also play from here. Let's go to apps. Go to all, where's my app? My product orders mobile. So if I play it, I will see the gallery in there with the information. Let's see. This is the app being played already. So I see all my products in here. Now if I go to my model-driven app, select this beer, Azores Pale Ale, and activate. And if I go to my app and refresh it, I will see the product in here already, because now this product is active here in the first row, and it's being shown here in the gallery because I'm filtering the gallery using the view. Very good, very nice. Now in the next video, we can add a search here in the top, and also enable to filter by category. I just have the beer category, but I will then add another product in here, just to be able to show different products and apply this filtering. Otherwise, it will show empty. So you also add to yours, and in the next video, we are going to add the search and filter by category. See you in the next video.